Hello friends, welcome back to Tomato Blues. Today we will be making a hot and sweet lemon pickle. So come on, let's go into the recipe. I have soaked around 20 to 25 medium sized lemons in a bowl of water for like 10 minutes. And then I have spread them on a cotton towel after draining them completely from the water. As you can see, all of the lemons are not even sized over here. I wasn't able to find them like that. So a few of them are big. And also I will be using a 1.5 liter capacity glass jar to make this pickle today. While we get the lemons prepped, we will also be sterilizing this jar parallelly. So I'm going to tell you how to sterilize a jar for making pickles today. To sterilize this jar, I have immersed this jar in a pressure pan that is of a 4.5 liter capacity. Make sure that there is water till the brim, or it covers the bottle completely. And now we are going to allow this to come to a rolling boil. So while this comes to a rolling boil, let's go and get the lemons prepped. As I said, I've spread the lemons on a clean cotton towel like this. So I'm waiting for them to become dry. I've just dried them in air. Also, don't forget to wash the lid in warm water and sun dry it thoroughly. If you're watching this video and you like our videos, don't forget to subscribe and also press the bell button for getting regular updates on your YouTube app. Let's now go and continue the recipe. So, like I said, we will have to not only air dry the lemons but also wipe them thoroughly dry using a cotton towel like this. This is just to make sure that there is no moisture in the lemons at all. If there is moisture in the lemons, then the pickles will get spoiled. So, which is why this step is very, very important. So, once you dry them, set them apart in a separate container or a pan. I'll be using 3/4 cup rock salt, 1.5 cup sugar and 1.5 cups vinegar for this recipe. This is actually Aegean sea salt that I'm using for this recipe. You can use regular rock salt too. You can also use brown sugar in place of white sugar in this pickle. So now let's go and see if the water has come to a rolling boil, and then let's get on with the sterilization further. So if you can see, the water has now begun to boil. Once this begins boiling rapidly, switch off the flame and then use a silicone gloves to remove this jar from the water. After this, we will have to dry the jar completely. So now I've switched off the flame. I used an induction pan to do this. I'm using a silicone mitt to remove this bottle from the water. I will be draining the hot water from the bottle, and then I will be placing it inverted on a cooling rack. If you do not have a cooling rack, you can also use a trivet or just use your drying rack that you use for drying your regular dishes. So this is my cooling rack that I use for cooling cakes. On this, I'm placing this inverted so that all the hot water gets drained completely. Do not wipe the jar with a towel or a tissue after this step. So now here you can see the dried lemons. We are now going to cut these lemons into 6 or 8 pieces. Choose a very sharp knife and make sure that you have washed the chopping board thoroughly and dried it as well. Like I said, no moisture is good for any pickle. So let's roll the lemons a little bit and give them a squeeze before we cut them. I'm going to chop them into 6 to 8 pieces depending on the size of the lemons. So the chopping process like took about 10 to 15 minutes for me for 20 to 25 lemons. So now if you can see, I've chopped it like this into quarters and I finished chopping all the lemons. So now we are going to be soaking the lemons in the glass jar. So I'm going to be adding half of the chopped lemon wedges into the glass jar. While you make any pickle, make sure that the working surface on which you're making the pickle is very, very clean, or else the pickles will get spoiled. So now I've added half of the lemon wedges into the glass jar. I'm going to be adding the rock salt now, and then the next step is going to be adding all the sugar. As I said, you can use jaggery or brown sugar in place of white sugar in this hot and sweet lemon pickle. So next, I will be adding about 1.5 cups of vinegar. You can also use artificial vinegar, but I strongly recommend natural distilled vinegar for making this hot and sweet lemon pickle. So I have added all the vinegar into this. Now I will be adding the remaining lemon wedges into this. Once I add the remaining lemon wedges, you can see that the jar is completely full. Do not let this bother you. If you are very particular, then you can also use two different sterilized jars to make this recipe. So this is how it looks. I'm now going to close this and let this sit for a week. Every day while this sits for a week, please make sure that you shake it well in the morning after you have a bath. So let's see how it looks after a week now. But now this is how it looks. So this is after a week. So if you can see, the lemons have become soft and the color has also changed a little bit. We are now going to prep this further by adding the required spices and also chili powder. This is a no oil lemon pickle. So now I have prepped a clean dry bowl. This bowl is also washed in warm water and soap. Now let's make the spice powder for this hot and sweet lemon pickle. Let's heat a pan and add 3 teaspoons of cumin seeds. The flame has to be at its lowest possible. Now I'm going to be adding 3 teaspoons fenugreek seeds. Next, I will be adding 7 to 8 cardamom pods and then 2 teaspoons of mustard seeds. Now we are going to be dry roasting this till the spices are fragrant and the fenugreek begins to turn a little pink in color. At this point, I'm going to add 2 teaspoons of asafoetida and fry further for 30 seconds. Now this is done. Once this is done, immediately transfer it to a plate and let it cool. And then in the same pan, add 2 to 3 teaspoons fennel seeds and dry roast this for like about a minute. Again, the flame has to be at its lowest. Now, let us grind all the roasted spices except the fennel seeds to a smooth powder. And let us add the roasted fennel and the ground powder to the lemons. We are going to be using a clean, dry wooden ladle to make this today. To this, I'm going to be adding 4 tablespoons of red chili powder. You can adjust this according to your spice requirement. So now I've taken a clean dry wooden ladle and now let's get on to mixing this pickle very well. Make sure that you do not use your hands whatsoever while making this pickle and that the ladle is completely dry while you mix this. So give it a nice mix until everything is completely and evenly distributed and mixed well. If you can see, the pickle is mixed and it's all shiny and glossy. It really looks like a treat. Now I'm going to be transferring the pickle to the same jar and letting it sit for like 2 days. This is how it looks after 2 days. And now let's scoop it up. If you can see, the spices are all nicely mixed and the lemons have softened further and the pickle has thickened. So this tastes excellent with curd rice, paratha, chapati, puri. So do try this and give me your feedback, friends. Thank you so much for watching. And like I said, please do not forget to subscribe and press the bell button if you're watching our channel. We'll meet you soon with another interesting recipe soon, friends. Thank you and take care.